nothing better than an empty gym, man. This is like a basketball heaven right here. If there's one brand that I would represent, you know, like dedicate myself to, it's this grit brand. And the guy who runs it, Doug, got nothing but respect for him. And the idea behind grit. So get it out the mud, man.
From a team perspective, it's gone really good. I kind of still wish we got a few of the tough ones that we dropped to end the break at 6-4. Like, that's all we could ask for considering such a tough schedule that we had. I'd like to be a bit better as far as just the consistency, like dealing with the pain and all that. I'd like to be more disciplined with how I'm dealing with the pain. So for me, it's just trying to stay locked in to each day and each game and not get caught up on the big ones in the schedule, because you can lose to all these teams on any given night. And they've all proven it, so. One thing coming into this year, I had this vendetta against all the big teams, because there was a lot of teams I never beat. Like, I never beat Calgary until last year with UBC. I never beat UBC. I beat Alberta one time with UBC, but I remember, like, I needed to go to the Trinity Western and beat all these teams. Because I don't know what it was, but I just, like, I want to take down all these Titans with Trinity Western. Like, I want to take down these big teams.
I'm new here, so I don't know, like, the past record of these past teams, but I heard Alberta was pretty good. We came to the mall. I think we're to beat them. Then next week, we beat UBCO. And then the last two games is dog walk, so. We'll be 8-0 in a year. We're like 16-4. Yeah, that's what I think. Yeah.
He don't believe it though. I believe it, really. I don't think he would believe it.
All right.
I don't know. Put a camera on him. Don't he look just like Ellen, bro? He looks just like Ellen, the TV show host. I swear.
If we run offense and make that many extra passes, we don't lose games. The thing is, when we get into games, we don't make those passes. The ball flows, shit looks pretty.
So happy we got a break, you know? That's why I always tell the team, because as team captains, just gotta let people know, like, it's where everybody stands, given the role. First day Mace came to practice, actually, I let him know that I'm the man. And
ow!
Ref.
Ow.
I did not do that.
Damn. Dude.
Oh, sorry. Sorry, my bad.
So thank you for this opportunity to play, to work together. Pray against injury or anything like that. Help us to play with focus and passion and trust. In your name, amen.
Amen. Spartans on three, family on six. 1, 2, 3, Spartans.
15% from three, maybe even the first half of this season. But yeah, he was down to about 17% from three, maybe even lower than that. And now they're going to go to Connor Platts. Tough catch, tough finish. The big man, Connor Platts. He was seeing his star rise in this season, on the season. These are two of the better offenses as Bourcier's three is good. Mason Bourcier, whose three ball resume has been skyrocketing as the season has gone on. Another person hits pavement, Gerson, the putback, and one for the big man. Big boss, I'm knowing I ain't hearing out of young Gerson. Double in the post. In a row. Finds a cutting, Vlad Mihaila, and he gets it to go. Juice. Back to Juice. Doesn't take many threes, but why not?
Take more, you fella.
Take more, I don't know. Got me posted out alone with the slums, be. Lot of money on the line, what I'm going for. You don't stick with me now, I don't run you. Bourcier, 2-on-2. Thought he wanted to go to Galupo, thought about it, and one. He'll take that instead. Had a look, he'll take it. It's good. Trey Fillmore filling it up from deep. Bourcier! Mason Bourcier, why do you have to do it like that? spin move in the lane with the lefty. Oh, don't do it, Mason Bourcier. It does matter, though. Like, yeah, you're scared of it. Another one. Bourcier knocked it free. Fillmore goes up. This time he lays it up. We've seen him throw down on guys before. Upline. Oh, my goodness. Yeah, pokes it up. This is keep going again. Mason Bourcier finds flats underneath. Two hands with the big man. And kind of got the step on him, and he did, like, here we go. Bourcier takes a bump, and he holds his ankle. He gets up right away.
I think he stepped on Ashimwe's lead foot there.
We had to win the game, and I'm just like, I'm sick of being injured. Like, I just didn't want to accept it, so I just acted like it didn't happen, to be honest. And then once I, like, just stood up, and I was like, oh, it's fine. Like, my mind kind of didn't worry about it, but it was by far the worst one of the entire year. Like, probably my whole career is the worst
DeAndre
one I've ever
Jordan
had.
Effect.
Yeah.
Bourcier, stop up, tries to find Platts, and he does somehow catch that. This time he goes to the hook shot, and it's good. Connor Platts now at double digits. Here's Fillmore, up to Platts.
Come on, Steve.
He asks, he delivers!
Right on cue.
High post Platts, wants Bourcier. Three-pointer. Yeah. That's why he wants him. Mason Bourcier up to 20 points now.
Scoreless in the last 94 seconds, too.
Mutabazi, his three on the wing is good. David Mutabazi, he's in double digits now. Four. Elton Brand, Steve Francis, Cohen,
yeah,
years.
Vlad Mihaila and Juice Belvin. For both of them off the bench, big sparks, big minutes.
91-77, the Spartans defeat the Golden Bears. They will do battle tomorrow night. Tip-off of that one is set for 7 o'clock. We'll have the call for you, for everyone here at the Langley Event Center on Canada West TV. Thank you for watching Canada West men's basketball action here on CanadaWest.tv. Until next time.
Show the ankle.
Oh, okay. Yo, check this. Ref. Should we get a light on? Oh, you got it.
Played on that, John.
Wait, the whole foot is crazy. Torn both sides, discolored.
I'm surprised, like, you can walk on it.
It doesn't hurt as bad as it looks, but I'm shocked I played on it. But then again, I think it just looks worse than it is.
It doesn't hurt that bad. Like, I'm jumping on it. Like, if you sat me out this weekend, I could get enough rest for the doctors, or like to do what the doctor told me to do, which is take 2 weeks off from my back and take like this medicine that he gave me, or this prescription. If you guys can win, that's all that matters. If you guys can win, you can win, you know what I'm saying? Well, not this bad on Friday, but it was really bad on the Saturday. Yeah. When I rolled it, it hurt really bad.
That's going to the clip, and I just cut.
Yeah, that actually felt good, bro. I could practice for real, though.
No.
I could practice, though.
Like, I'm sure
you're
not.
Yo, you see that? Bro, come on. Yo, what, like, okay.
And I just thought it was so, like, ironic that my whole career, I've been known as, like, the durability guy, the Iron Man. Like, I played every game. Like, I never missed games. I played every game, every practice up until that point in my career. So I thought it was ironic that my last home game ever, seniors night, the night you think a lot about as an athlete, is like the one time I won't play. And so I had to sit there and like kind of like meditate on that. But it allowed me, like, not practicing, it allowed me to sit in the gym. I had a lot of like time to just reflect on the whole career, man, and think about everything that happened and like where I ended up. And it was like, it's been a beautiful journey, man. I got to think about all of it in perspective of the whole for however many days I didn't practice, you know.
When Nationals are going around, we need you helping. And you're not playing with that, so.
Yeah, I can't, yeah.
Let your family know. Maybe your senior night, we'll bring you out there.
I know. That's crazy.
I think it's the best move for you, though.
Yeah,
you
probably.
Because I think you going down the stretch of the season, like, yeah, being healthy is more important.
Yeah, I just hope we win the games, at least.
We will.
Yeah.
We'll beat them.
Oh, this shit's ugly.
That was bad.
Yeah, it's crazy. I've never seen it like that before. But it doesn't hurt, that's the thing. Like, the pain isn't there, so I don't know what that means. But I played every game except the most important one.
Did you see that?
I did.
No, it's just, am I surprised?
hard work gets results.
Nope. Hard work gets results. That's the fact, you know? Good coaching gets results. Your best asset as a player is reliability. Or no. Availability. Availability. That's what it is.
Yale. He's one of the most disciplined and consistent workers I've ever been around. DL was always there for me, always saying encouraging things, always wishing the best. He genuinely wants the best for everyone. He wants everyone to win, everyone to succeed. He shows up every day, gets his dynamic warm-up in. He goes to the lift and he's lifting the most. He records all the weight. Like, he does all the little things that you want like an athlete to do, or if you have a kid growing up, you want him to do that stuff, you know? So he does a great job of living out what he talks about, you know?
He's on Last Chance View on Netflix. If you go to the sixth episode, he got his seventh episode.
Hey, but he was getting better.
Get smacked.
Does it feel bittersweet that tomorrow's gonna be your last, or Saturday's gonna be your last home game?
I think it's more so bitter because I love playing at the LEC, and I've never like had a fan base like TWU 300, so I'm gonna miss playing here for sure.
And Trey came with me the same year from Texas, you know. We showed up the same class and both had no idea what we were getting ourselves into, just kind of threw ourselves into it. And it ended up being a great, I think, I thought a great duo in the backcourt. It was a lot of fun playing with him, with a sniper like that. By week four of our first year, he had teams face guarding him because he was lighting the entire country up. That's one thing, it's like tough because I'm always trying to get him the ball and I look over and teams are just like, covering him everywhere we go, you know. So like the respect he got right away in Canada is it shows how he is as a player.
Boy got two plays up there. Look at me, boy. Two plays. No one else.
I got a play. I mean, I'm late in a 10, baby.
Him and Trey both had like big hearts, man. Not just for the game, but for people. It's so misunderstood. You guys care so much about people and like trying to make others feel good and trying to spread love. And it makes it tough because, you know, like, it's hard not to see it get reciprocated, but like you see, like, they just care a lot. That's like their biggest blessing and curse at the same time. I just saw all the guys having fun, like Juice playing really well, did a great job stepping in. Yeah, Trey had his big performances.
Pass. It's Fillmore. Drives with the left hand, and that's good. Trey Fillmore got a little bit of the space for Spickens.
Hey, let's go, Drew. Drew!
Throw it up.
Yeah, Drew.
Andrew Griffin's right in the ground.
Let's go, Drew.
Right to the defense, and one!
Yeah!
Oh my God!
Oh! Austin was doing his thing. You know, Austin's always doing his thing. That's the thing I love about him. He's always doing his thing, man.
This guy said,
it is nice to like see the guys pull up and like have an exciting game. And we have a team, man. Like, we have a very good team. Like, we have 6-7 guys that can play at a really high level in that rotation, you know.
She's trying to lead me on low down. I ain't with savage.
They doing, we don't, I don't know how. Run through the low car, the plug, I need more pounds. I put on drip every day from the floor.
I'm getting sick of it. Clay Pottinger calls for time. Hey,
continues to be the theme
watch
of the night.
Watch inbounder, hey, watch inbounder, Dave. Juice, watch inbounder after. Woo! found it. And they move up now to 10-5 on in the season. UBCO drops to 5-10.
After the game, once I got home after the game, I'm like, I'm playing tomorrow, you know?
Andrew was, he was like the first guy that I met on campus at Trinity in my first year. Him and Ethan De Silva. I don't know, he's kind of like always been there like my whole journey. Someone that I could reach out to and talk to if ever I need anything. Spiritual leader on the team all the way up until this past year. Don't miss him for sure.
Andrew, going through senior night round two. He's really been like my dad though, you know, like he's let me stay on his floor for a long, like when I was going through a really tough time, him and his roommates, Tyler Jones and Dan Stead at the time, they were all rooming together. They let me stay on their floor, gave me a home when I didn't really have one at the time in Langley, and just allowed me to like kind of work through my stuff at the time when I was dealing with everything and joke around. They understood my situation, so that was really cool of them to help me out like that.
I'm gonna miss like, just like the team, bro. Like the environment, like that's why I came back. Like, just like being around the guys, like you never get this again. You never get this anywhere else. It's been a long 6 years, but I'm ready. I'm really ready to be done. I'm ready.
Getting to learn to play with Andrew after competing against him my whole career was cool because we really started to form a good bond at the end, and we really learned how to play well together. So that was a lot of fun. Isaiah Ron, he was one of the best teammates I've ever had. One of the greatest human beings I've ever been around. One of the most mature people. He's the kind of guy that you will never have to worry about. You can always depend on. He was just a stone for us last season, like an absolute rock for us. I wish he played this year, but whatever situation he was going through, like we fully understand and support him through it, so.
I mean, I've had a few last seasons, but last one good, gotta make the challenge.
Dan Stead, one of my closest friends on the team, one of the smartest dudes you'll ever be around. He's taught me things that I've never learned from other people. And he was like Isaiah with the professionalism that he brought to the team, and it was like much needed. Him coming back this year was like one of the biggest additions for our team. So shout out to him.
It's weird because like usually senior night's like at the end of the year, and I feel like we still got like a whole semester to go through, but you know, it's the last home game and you always love playing at home more, so it's a little bittersweet.
Like all these guys that we went through so much in a 2 year span as human beings, where it's like we'll always have that connection. They're always like family, you know, like they'll always be welcome to my home, like anything like that. Anyone from this team, man, anyone from this team is a friend for life. Like these guys are all just high level human beings, like just amazing people. DC. Like I can't not play for my last home game, you know? It was just, all right, Advil, tape, whatever I need. I had to, you know, last home game, and it's LEC, like that place, I played there since I was grade 7. Every major event pretty much has been there, like regionals, provincials, my first camp ever, my top 50 camp was there. So I had to like end it and go out with a bang somehow, you know?
Have a senior night, Andrew Kirkson, Langley Hoops legend.
Back to Bourcier, he's got Chief Maddie on, we'll let it fly. It's good! Mason Bourcier, who's been a flamethrower in the second half of this season. Liberty. Back to Bourcier. To Fillmore. That's his spot. That's his corner. He's hit some big shots in his limited 2 years here at the program.
Vlad hit one of the coldest shots I've ever seen.
Mihaila all alone in the corner. It's good. Vlad Mihaila. Bourcier, 8 seconds of the shot clock. He's hit his first three, misses his second. That ball deflects right to the hands of Stead. Bourcier trying to draw contact. It's a friendly roll. Mason Bourcier, 5 points now, 4 assists already in this first half. 6 seconds on the game clock. They go to the corner. Mihaila, 3 ball. Corner pocket! And that'll tie this game up going to halftime.
Big shot.
It wasn't pretty at times, but the Spartans claw back. Not this one up at 38. Now he'll take it. Catch and shoot. 3! Same result. If it's a corner, Trey Fillmore. It's like a layup for him. Round the closeout. Thought about leaving for flash. He said instead. Nice 3 at the top. It's good. Spartans are a flamethrower to start this second half. His floater is good. Fillmore trying to push. He's 2-on-1. Eurostep takes contact and 1. Rockets. A new player to the era, Daniel Stead, on his senior night having his best offensive output this season. At the lane, leaves it for Platt. Floater in the lane. They are automatic with that pick and roll game between the two of them.
Fillmore.
He'll let it fly from deep. Trey Fillmore. Starting him a lot closer. Creates a little bit of space. Three ball. It's good! He's a flamethrower!
Trey Fillmore's feeling himself.
Bourcier, 7 seconds. He's got Gavin Ashworth on him. Step back. Three to end the quarter.
Mason knew as soon as he let it go. That was going down.
72-62. The shooting from the Spartans, the difference in that third quarter. I forgot to bring this up as Fillmore. His three continues the hot shooting.
Did his parents know he was going to be a gunner when they named him Trey?
Now Fillmore's got Chooks Natty on him. He leaves it. Here's the heat check.
No. This is Trey Fillmore's night. We're just living in it.
Good boy.
To Fillmore. Here it is. The crowd will tell you if it goes.
That was a 30-footer.
With a hand in his face.
Just let's go home.
And the horn goes. And that'll be the way this one ends. Two games by the skin of their teeth. With the Spartans pull off two close victories, 94-91, to sweep the series, and then their home record here in the 2022-23 season.
Taught me a lot, and you know I'm where I am today. And the one thing he taught me too is to never give up. So even though my situation is not crazy good right now, I may not be the best player on the court. That'll always be my dream, and I'm gonna keep striving to get it because I know that's what he can do.
Mason never ever disagreed with anything I was doing, and that's hard as a player to take. So, and he took all the criticism I gave him. It's not about basketball for me now, right? I worry about different things for you guys, even you as an ex-player, like your life, being good humans, right? Moving on. You know, I know he loves to play basketball, but sometimes when I talk to him now, I'm like, okay, what are you gonna do after basketball? And I, you know, he's geared, his mind is focused on never not playing basketball. So I try to get him to think a little bit beyond that, but I get it, he's in the moment. And like anything, you pull for your guys. So I only want the best for him. Yeah.
Final words is don't let what we've started to build die off. There's a lot of sacrifices made to start building this program and the seeds that we've started to plant. The only way that this all dies down is if we get complacent, but I really don't want that to stop the next 5 years. Like I want to create something lasting, especially for Trevor, who's given me these opportunities. I'm gonna miss the late nights and just hanging out, and I'm gonna miss going on the road with teammates, and the most fun part was being in the airports and stuff, you know, like I'm gonna miss all that stuff. So, but yeah, I'm ready for the next step. I've experienced it all. I can happily say I was like present for everything.
I feel like a chip on my shoulders. I feel like I'm losing my focus. I feel like I'm losing my patience. I feel like my thoughts in the basement. I feel like you're miseducated. Feel like I don't wanna be bothered. I feel like you may be the problem. I feel like it ain't no tomorrow. Fuck the world. The world is ending. I'm done pretending. And fuck you if you get offended. I feel like friends been overrated. I feel like the family been faking.
I know we've had our ups and downs. Have even fought a couple of times. I won.
See Dale right there in the green? With the camera right there? It's connected right to him. He can hear what I'm saying. He can hear what you're saying.
No.
You don't believe me? Watch this.
No.
Dale, give me a wave. See? Woo!
Yo, I agree. I agree with him.
Hey, if you need math 191, that's where you need to be. Glenn Van Brummelen, he's a GOAT. He's going to be speaking at chapel tomorrow. Let him know.
Hey, shout out to chapel, though. Shout out to chapel. If you're not going to chapel,
no one wants to hear you sing, David.
It's not about my voice. It's about the words I'm talking about.
even the selfish acts are still in selfish nature. You just want people to hear you sing, buddy.
God forbid. That's not true at all, actually. As I'm worshiping, I'm actually just trying to create a space where we can worship God together. It's not even about me. I pray that I become invisible. So the Lord becomes invisible. Come on, somebody. Hey. You know what I'm saying? Come on. What?
Yeah.
Got it. What is me, bitch?
Fill up the graves with fathers, fill up the babies with bullshit. Internet blogs and pulpit.